Hello, I'm Eric Hammond with Colorado State University Extension in Adams County, and we're here today to talk about the basics of soil. Particularly, we're going to talk about what soil is made of. Soil, when you think about it by volume, has two general components. There's the physical stuff, the dirt, if you will, and then there's the space between the dirt, the empty spaces we call those pore spaces. The solid component can either be mineral, so the weathered rocks of the earth, or it can be organic matter. Organic matter does a lot of good stuff for us as gardeners, and ideally we'd have about 5% organic matter in our soil. Here we just have a brief demonstration to illustrate what pore space is and why it's important. So we have two containers full of soil. It's the same soil, just straight out of the garden. One of them I'm gonna compact. So I'm gonna push it down into the container, and it seems like I'm reducing the amount of soil that's there, but that can't be right. All the solid stuff that was in the container is still gonna be there. We've maybe packed it down about an inch. So think for a second about what was lost here. The mineral component still has the same volume. What did we lose? It's the spaces between. So when we compact soil, we lose the spaces between the mineral particles. They're pushed out and the soil particles are pushed closer together. This means the soil has less pore space to hold water and air, and particularly less pore space to hold air, which is a big deal because your plant roots need oxygen, which is stored in those larger pore spaces that we just pushed out of the soil. So we have a second demonstration here about soil properties and pore space in particular. So we have the same two soils from our first example, the uncompacted soil and the compacted soil. The compacted soil has had a lot of the pore spaces eliminated by pushing the soil particles closer together. So we're now going to add a half cup at a time water to each one, and we're going to see what happens. So right away, you notice water goes into the uncompacted soil much more quickly. Compacted soils have smaller pore space, which means infiltration rates, the rate the water moves into the soil, are much slower. So we're watching here. You can see the water moving down through the compacted soil, whereas the other one's already absorbed it. That's a really good example. Okay, so we've waited a couple minutes here, and you can see that, again, the uncompacted soil has absorbed the full half cup of water, no problem. There's still a little bit of water on the surface of the compacted soil that probably will slowly absorb in over the next few minutes. What we're going to do now is add just a little bit more water to demonstrate that the pore space in the compacted soil is pretty much all full. Again, a little more may be absorbed slowly, and there's still pore space in the uncompacted one because, we didn't push out the pores through compaction. So here we go. Probably about half. Right there's good, yeah. So pretty much the same amount of water added to each. And again, you can see the uncompacted soil has pretty much absorbed it all, no problem. That's water that your garden plants can use, can absorb to grow, and you'll notice that in this case, the water that's on the surface, some of it will slowly absorb in, but what would happen is that water would be lost to runoff or something else and not available for plants. On top of all of that, the water that is in this soil is held more loosely by the soil, and it's more easy for plants to get absorb, whereas the water in the compacted soil is held more tightly and is harder for plants to use. So what's this mean for us as gardeners? We want to have uncompacted soil so that we can maximize the amount of water that it stores for our plants to use. Thanks for watching. See the CSU Extension website and the Grow and Give page for more educational resources.